let's do an example. This example will help us to understand these equations and will also help us to develop our intuition about elliptic curves. So in this example, we have given an elliptic curve and a point P on that elliptic curve, and we have to solve these five different parts. The first part we have to find 2P, the second part we have to find 3P, then we have to find minus P, and we have to calculate P minus P, and lastly we have to calculate 26P. So let's start with the part number A. In the part A, we have to find 2P, and 2P is basically point doubling. So I'm doubling a point, so I will use the tangent method, and for that I will be using this slope. So I will use this slope and these equations to find 2P. So 2P, first I will start with the slope. S is equals to 3x1, and here we have this one is x1 and this one is x2. So we have this one as x1 and this one is y1. So we have x1 and y1. So we have 3x1, and 3 times 5 square plus a, and this is our a and this is our b, plus 2 divided by 2 times y1, and y1 is 11, mod 17, and it will be like 3 times 25 plus 2 over 22 mod 17, and this will be 75 plus 2 is 77 over 22 mod 17. So 77 is 9 in mod 17, and 22 is 5 in mod 17. So we will have 9 over 5 mod 17. And now we have to find 9 times 5 inverse mod 17. And the answer will be 63. In mod 17, which is equals to 12. So the slope is 12. So now we will use this slope to calculate 2p using these two equations. So first we compute x3, which is basically the x coordinates of 2p. S square is like 12 square plus minus x1 was 5, minus x2, and x2 was also 5, because we are doing point doubling, so x1 and x2 is same, more 17. So basically, because we are adding p in p in the point doubling, so x1 and y1 it belongs to P, and x2 and y2 also belongs to P. So that's why we have x2 is also 5. So the answer is 144 minus 10 mod 17 and s equals to 134 mod 17, and which is equals to 50. So x3 is 50, and now I have to find y3, and y3 is equals to, I will use this equation, is like 12, x1 is 5, minus x3 is 15, and minus y1, and y1 was 11 mod 17, which is 12 times minus 10 minus 11 mod 17, and which is equals to minus 120 minus 11 mod 17, m which is equals to minus 131 mod 17, and 131 in mod 17 is equals to 5. So y3 is 5. Hence we have answer of our first part, and the first part we have p 2p is equals to 15 comma 5. So 2p is equals to 15 comma 5. Now let's solve the second part. In the second part, I have to find 3p. So I have to find 3p. So let's do part number b, and I have to find 3p, and 3p is equals to p this plus and 2p, this special plus and 2p. So we have basically coordinates of x1 and y1 associated with p. We have coordinates of x2 and y2 associated with 2p, and what we have to find is x3 and y3. Let's write down what we already know. We know x1 and y1. X1 is 5 and y1 is 11. We know x2 and y2, and x2 is 15 and y2 is 5, and we have to find x3 y3. So in this case, I can't use point doubling because it is not adding two same points. Point doubling can be used when p is equals to q. Here, obviously, p and 2p are two different points, so point doubling cannot be used. I have to use the code method for point addition. So I will use this slope. So once again, I will start from the slope. So let's calculate s. S is equals to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So y2 minus y1 is 5 minus 11 over x2 minus x1 is 15 minus 5. And this is basically minus 6. And this one is 10 mod 17. So what we have to do is like minus 6 in mod 17, 11 times 10 inverse mod 17, and the answer is 30. So the slope is, in this case, is 30. So now I have slope, and I have to use the slope to find x3 and y3 using these two equations. So x3 is equals to 13 square minus x1. X1 was 5 minus x2. X2 is 15, and this is like 169 minus 20, and this is 149 mod 17, and 149 mod 17 is 30. So x3 comes out to be 30. So now I have to find the y coordinates, which is y3. So y3 is equals to, I'm using this equation, which is 13 x1 minus x3. X1 is 5, and x3 is 13 minus 13 minus y1, and y1 is 11. So basically it is 13 minus 8 minus 11, and this is minus 115 mod 17, and that is basically equals to 4. So y3 is equals to 4. At 3p, and the answer is 13 comma 4. So now let's do the third part. In the third part, I have to find minus p. The c part, I have to find minus p. And before finding minus p, let's clear the logic. Elliptic curve are symmetric along x-axis, So basically, they are mirror image, the both side of x is mirror image to each other. So we have given a point P, assume that the point P is somewhere here. And we have to find point minus P. So point minus P will be somewhere here. Will be point minus P will be the image of point P. In case the point P coordinates are x1, y1, then the point minus P coordinates, x coordinate will be same, because you can see that the x coordinates is obviously same because they are the same line. So we have x1 here once again, and the y coordinates will be additive inverse of y1. So the y coordinates will be, in this case, the y coordinate will be 17 minus y1. If we have some other prime number, then we have to subtract that prime number to find additive inverse. So in our case, we have the answer of part C is something like that. We have minus P is equals to x1, and x1 means that same that we have here. So x coordinate is same, and the y coordinates are 17 minus 11. So minus P is equals to 5 comma 6. So that's it. That is the answer of our part C. So now let's do the part D. In the part D, we have to calculate P minus P. So in the part D, we have to calculate P minus P. Now we cannot use either of point doubling and point addition to calculate P minus P. There basically a special rule which helps us to calculate P minus P. The answer is identity element. And the answer is identity element. And the identity element is a special imaginary element that we have defined in the last video. And that imaginary element that is either on the positive infinity or the negative infinity. So the answer is identity element, which is that special imaginary element. So that's the answer of part D. So now let's do part E. In the part E, we have to find 26P. So the part E, we have to calculate 26P. Part E is 26P. So how to calculate 26P is that first I will calculate 2P, and then I will calculate 3P, and then calculate 4P, and then so on. And after maybe 25 different computations, I will have 26P. And this will take obviously a very long time. So we have a better solution to calculate 26P. And this solution is known as a double and add algorithm. So in the next video, we'll solve this problem using double and add algorithm. So stay tuned.